Let us understand the uses of lambda functions. Lambda functions are typically used while invoking those functions which take functions as arguments. Here are some of the functions which we can see immediately. However, you might not be able to understand these concepts. When you actually go through the collections, you will be able to get the concepts clear. In this case, I just want to emphasize that lambda functions are extensively used as part of our day-to-day activities, and hence you should be comfortable with them. Filter, map, sorted, etc. are some of the examples. There are many Python modules which have functions which take other functions as arguments. We will see quite a lot of examples in upcoming chapters. Wherever there are functions which will take other functions as arguments, we tend to use lambda functions wherever we have to pass simple functionality to the higher order functions. Let's look at the help of filter. You can see that filter takes two arguments. One is of type function or none. Second one is of type iterable. When it comes to map, the first argument is of type function. Second argument is of type varying iterables, which means we can pass multiple collections after the first argument, which is of type function. When it comes to sorted, the second argument is key. The first argument is iterable. As part of this keyword parameter or argument, you can actually pass a lambda function to determine what should be used as key to sort the data. We will see examples with respect to the three so that you understand the usage of lambda functions while invoking these functions. I have created a users collection or list. Users is of type list. There are 20 elements. Each element is of type string. You can actually say type of users here. It is of type list. You can also say type of users of 0, which will give the type of the first element, and it is of type string. So we have a list of strings, and from them, I just want to filter for those records or for those strings which have male in them. I just want to ignore which have female in them. If you look at each of these strings, they are comma separated, and the fifth element have the gender. So the first element is user ID, second element is first name, third element is last name, fourth element is email ID, and the fifth element is gender. I just want to get records like these which have male in them. So I have used the filter, and I tend to process each and every record by splitting using comma as delimiter and by extracting the fifth element using this logic, and then by comparing with male. So whatever record satisfies this will be added to this males, and finally you will see only males in this. So out of 20, only 6 are males, and you can see those details here. Now if you want to get all those who are either male or female, there are null values also, and if you want to discard those things, you can simply improvise on this by saying in and then male comma female, like this. And you can see both male and female records here. Some of them are missing. If you want to get the size of it, you can just say len of unisex. Let me, or both genders. Let me actually say male and females. Let me give this as name here, just to make sure that it makes sense. For some reason, it is not giving me the number of elements. I just have to convert the output of the filter to a list. By default, filter returns some special type. I just want to convert it into list to use len to get the length. As the data is already processed, it is showing 0 here. We need to run this again. What I need to do is I have to copy this once again, and then I have to run. Now you see there are 17 either males or females. Only 3 are not either male or female, or neither male or female. Probably they might not have chosen to give their gender details. Now out of these 20 records, there are IP addresses, and I want to extract the IP addresses, which is the last element in the record along with the user ID. So I have created a map object called as user IPs, and I have applied the logic to extract the user ID and the last element, which is nothing but the IP address. You need to have some level of understanding with respect to the collections. As I haven't covered those yet, you might not get everything clear now, but you can use this as an example to just demonstrate lambda function can be used to transform the data as part of our map function. So in this case, for each and every record, we got the user ID and the IP address. Few things are missing. I don't know why it is missing. It should not be missing. Our original data have 3, but still 3 did not come up here. I need to figure out. So 3 is missing. Only 3 is missing. I don't know why 3 is missing. Yeah, probably with respect to 3, everything looks good. For some reason, the 3 is not coming up, which is not correct. Let me first validate my users to make sure that I am processing the entire dataset. It is very important to validate these things upfront. So as part of the users itself, I don't have 3. Okay, I know why. So the problem is, in this case, there is no comma. That's why it got confused. Now it should work. We should also see 3 as part of the results. Now you can see that I got both user ID as well as the IP address for 3. For 2 and 9, there are no IPs. That's why it is showing empty string here. Also, you can use lambda functions as part of the sorted. As part of the key, you can specify the key using which the data can be sorted. In this case, I'm trying to sort the data by gender and then by ID. Now, if I run this, first we are getting those records where there is no gender specified. Then all the females, because female comes ahead of male as part of the sorting order. When we try to use female and male as keys to sort the data, that's why we got all the female records up to here. Then the records related to male. So these are the male records. Let me select these things. So this is how you can actually sort the data. After sorting by gender, as there are multiple records for each gender, we have sorted the data in ascending order by ID. That's why we have this additional logic. If you don't specify int, it will actually sort alphanumeric, not numeric, and you will be seeing incorrect results, which is not correct. That's why we have to use int so that data is sorted as expected. If I remove int here and if I run this, you see here with respect to IDs for the females, after getting all 10, 11, 13, 14, 16, 18, 20, then comes 4, 6, and 8 because the data is sorted as alphanumeric, not numeric. But if I add int, it will work as expected. This is how you can actually use lambda functions on day-to-day basis while invoking the functions which take other functions as arguments. As long as the functionality is simple, you can pass it as lambda function. If the functionality is very complicated, which requires assignment and also returning values at different steps based on the conditions and all, you have to create a named function and you have to use the named function instead of lambda function. In all these places where we have used lambda functions, such as this one, and this one, we can even use named functions. The function should be taking other functions as arguments. In that place, either we can pass named functions or lambda functions. As long as the functionality is simple, we can leverage lambda functions for that.